I was just drawn for like 2 minutes. I had, bro, there's a tree dead between us. Dead between. He's feeding, but I think he's smaller than the one you killed at Fat Tuesday. I mean, he's that size, you know. Like he's 2.5. Like that looks like a great shot right there. Like he looks good from that angle. It's so hard of a call, dude. So hard of a call. And like your dad said, when you see one like this and you walk it, a lot of times you'll see a bigger one. You ought to see my arrow is shaking right now. I'm so nervous. It's the same buck I saw yesterday. Yeah. He heard that long can, bro. He came straight to it. That pissed him off. That thing might be a shooter, bro. Oh, he's a shooter. I think he's a shooter. Oh, yeah, he's definitely a shooter. See him still. I can see him still. Oh, he's pretty, dude. He's pretty. I shot low. I tried to sling one, but he was running. He's walking over there still. Wave at us. Successful hunt, brother. Anytime you can set up and have a shoot a buck come in between you and your partner at 20 yards, if he come right through here, I was about to shoot. I guess I could have shot him right here, but there was a little bit of branches and stuff in the way. T had a better shot. He took it. He was on the other side. I mean, I might have could even shot him there, but he was kind of quartering too. And I don't know, this was kind of iffy. I might not even have gotten an opportunity.
Hit him in the guts. Oh, look, that's some blood.
Yeah, lots of blood. Well, not a lot.
Which direction?
Right that way. I'll stay on this blood until you find the blood on the other side.
Toilet paper is a great way to mark blood trail because you can leave it in the trees at your last blood, you know, and then the first time it rains, it's just going to dissolve. So we know where our blood trail's at. We know we kind of hit it this way. He wasn't sure what he wanted to do, and his wound kind of closed up, but he kind of was wandering around over in this. And I felt like I heard him crash over back this way. Like, to our right, even some more.
And ran on him, and he was bedded down, and I shot and missed clean at like 20 yards with the pistol, and he jumped up. Your pistol jammed. So like, I tried to put another one in him.
He ran?
Yeah, he's hurt though.
You missed him clean,
huh? You have your drone on the bike?
No.
Yeah, he's hurt. Come meet me and we can mark it.
Mark your spot on the GPS and I'll come to you.
Okay.
Why do we need Helga?
Shut up.
Why do we need Helga, T? Huh? Who's your dog, bro? Oh!
Where is he?
Right over
here, man. I'll show you my friend, I mean. Come on through here. Come on through here. Come on through here. Let me show you my friend, I mean. Huh? Yeah.
What? What?
Oh, he's done, bruh. Done. Beautiful, bruh. Beautiful.
Hey.
Hold on, I gotta send LJ a pic.
I found the deer. I text him a picture of you with the deer while he's over there walking to the four wheeler.
Telling Steve to come help.
Tell Steve he needs a dog.
This dude's nice, bro.
Beautiful.
Hey.
Hey. What?
Bruh.
Hold on, I gotta take
this. This is great.
Oh, yeah, hold the light. Hold the light.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Let me get a picture of you with him.
Hold on, I gotta.
Right where he's laying. Oh, yeah. Here's a video right here.
Hold on, let me take the selfie.
Selfie?
We're late for Lacey.
Dude, good dog, he's a man, dude. That's beautiful.
Look at all that trash he's got.
Oh, dude.
Terrible.
No question about it. Like, terrible shot.
Liver.
Terrible shot.
Liver.
But, hey, look
how everybody tried to go for long and hard. You gotta get that liver, dog.
Bro, he had to shoot a little far back because there was a vine in his way, he said.
What?
Hey.
Bro, what? I told you.
That's my dog.
Gosh, dog.
He always closes the deal, man.
Bro.
A little bit far back, but look at this. Look at this guy.
What?
Look at this guy.
What?
This is man, you just don't know how much time we spend out here in the woods seeing nothing. And for this to happen, and for us to get it on film, we both drew at the same time. He mamped her. He got the window. He shot. He's always a great shot under pressure. A dog, T, always closes the deal. Like, I've learned a lot from him, but I'm still not the bow hunter he is, but I'm getting there. I'm just two seconds behind him on the draw. And you know, that's how it goes. But dude, we had this guy sandwiched between us, 20 yards from both of us. His window just came a little bit before mine did. And man, dude, this guy's beautiful. Oh, brother. Well, like, what a great hunt. It's so scary when you shoot a deer and you know, and you don't find him right away. T jumped this buck up. You guys heard me on the phone with him.
Shot him, tried to shoot him with a pistol.
He had the pistol. He had this buck at 20 yards, had the pistol, shot, missed, clean missed with the pistol. And then we decided to back out, hunt the evening, went back to Bullwinkle, got skunked in Bullwinkle, saw a few button bucks and stuff, but and then came back out here. It took us 20 minutes to find him. He was about 20 or 30 yards from where we had last blood before we gave up earlier. Man, what a gorgeous deer.
What
a gorgeous deer. This is one for the books right here, guys. This is, man. You know, we get an opportunity for a few days once a year to do this. We don't get to hunt as much as we'd like to, but when we get to put it together like this, I don't care who pulls the trigger, we catch it on film. Like, this is just unbelievable, man. This is a good time. This is what we do this far, man. This is great. Look at this guy. Oh yeah, bro. T closes the deal. T.
Gosh, dog. Bro, you gotta have a buddy that can close the deal.
He came in there shaking his head. He came in there, like, you know, kicking up the leaves. I got it all on film.
Gorgeous deer, dude.
Let me carry the gun out and get you dragging him out.